Yeah, it's okay. Thank you.
Good luck.
So now David will introduce us to his newest browser. Should we put this more? Is it fine?
Yeah.
Is it fine?
Yeah.
Oh, it's good.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Hi everyone. In case you know me, my name is David. My project is a browser. It's called Flow. It's a new type of browser, and it's an answer to the question, how might we manage information overload on the web? So what's the problem? Randy won't be around forever. So why don't you have these? I started collecting them when I was your age. My open tabs. Finished my work child. Does anyone have this problem? If you do, it's most likely your browser is not well designed to deal with that issue. So how do we get here? This is the very first browser from 1990. It didn't have a back button. Every link opened as a window. So naturally, you might think that leads to too many windows. So very quickly, people invented a back button. But that's still not enough. So a few years later, people finally invented tabs. And you think that might be enough, but no. Then everyone started having this problem with way too many tabs. So I came across this design challenge in 2007, and that really started me thinking about this issue ever since. And I haven't stopped. So first, what does research says about, what does the research say about this? Mozilla had a study in 2010 about tab browsing. They saw people very clearly divided into power users and casual users. So the 21 people that they studied, 17 of them, tab switching was much more common than using a back button. So in order to revisit a page, you switch tabs, you don't use a back button. On the other hand, for the casual users, the other people, for one of them, the person who had the lowest tab creation rate, he was also the same person who had the highest back usage. So these things are correlated, it seems to me. For power users, they said that they habitually opened links in new tabs, so they rarely actually just clicked that link, it was always in a new tab. And for casual users, 9 almost never opened links in a new tab, so some of them didn't even realize that feature even existed. So they were very clearly divided into different types of behavior. And these Norman group had a very similar study in 2015, and they found that millennials are most likely to be page parkers, which means that they go open a bunch of links for later, and then once they've done searching for the links to open, then they go through all the links and address them and go through them. On the other hand, older users are more likely to be parallel browsers, which means that they have several tabs open for different tasks, and each one within that task they will be pogo sticking between the central hub and all the links that it links to. So they'll go to a link, go back, go to another link, go back, and keep going back and forth. And Firefox last month had a Twitter poll. Which was interesting because they asked how many tabs you have open right now, and what we see is that 53% of people had 10 or more open tabs at that moment. And look at that, 20% of people said, don't judge me. So who knows how many tabs they had open. This is clearly an issue that a lot of people have. I was curious, since browsers are very easily, very well designed for multitasking, because all the tabs are right there, it's very easy to multitask. So is that going to have an issue for your life? And I found that certain people are actually heavy media multitaskers. These are very specific types of people. And these people are more susceptible to irrelevant stimuli. And they're less capable of filtering out irrelevant tasks. And they're actually slower at task pushing than people who are not light media multitaskers. So, which is ironic, because these are the people who are more likely to be switching tasks all the time. So you're wasting a lot of time. So if the browser can somehow help you not get distracted, that would be good. I did a competitive analysis to see how other people solve this problem. I came across these research browsers, which were interesting, and there are a bunch of browser features and add-ons. That tree-style tab is especially interesting if you want to look into it. There are all these other tab organizers that require a lot of manual organization, these other ones, and these other ones. So basically, a lot of manual work, except for a few of these, two of these, basically. It's a lot of manual work, or a lot of UI that helps you deal with this. So I'd like to try to sell that a little better. I came to a number of insights based on all that, everything, my years of thinking about this and all that research. First, the personas of people who are browse the web. There are actually two different types of people. There's first the Palo browser, who tends to be older, uses fewer tabs, and because of that, because they open links at the same time usually, and the way they revisit pages then is because of the back button, and so each tab is a different task. So the advantage of this is that all the tasks are separated. So each tab is the same is a different task. But on the other hand, they spend a lot of time going back and forth. It's a big waste of time. And on the other hand, the page parker is going to be younger. They're going to have many, they usually have many tabs open because they all usually open links to new tabs rather than the same tab, which means that to revisit the pages, they switch tabs. And therefore, each task is many tabs and all together. So the problem is that all the tasks are intermixed together. It's hard to keep track of what's what. And on the other hand, page revisitation is much easier. You just switch tabs and you go back and forth very easily. So what I'd like to do, actually, is try to combine the positives of that one and positives of the other and remove the negatives. That's what we really ideally like to do here. So to really drill down, we have specific problems with tab browsing. First, there's a problem with tab triage. That's because that's the issue that tabs are all intermixed. There's no visible structure. You see this, for example, that's email, that's school, that's entertainment, that's shopping, that's reading. They're all different tasks, but they're all right next to each other. It's hard to keep track. Also, there's tab finding. You know, once you have all these tabs, it's impossible to find and identify something. It's just easy to lose. Let's say you want to have something that's really important in there, but just get lost and then you'll never find it. Like, where's Waldo? Has anyone found him yet? Right there.
Yes.
Thirdly, there's an issue of page revisitation. So to get back to a page, it's not just always in a tab. Sometimes it's behind the back button or behind the forward button. Sometimes it gets lost behind these things. Like, for example, let's say I open a link in a new tab. So now it's over there. Now I'm going to close the original tab, okay? And now, let's say I realize, this is not good for me, I want to go back, but look, the back button is disabled because the browser has decided not to copy over the history. So now you'll never be able to find that page again. Because there's no, again, the browser doesn't keep track of the structure. Finally, it's very easy to lose your focus or your state of flow because there are always time wasters. Because multitasking, you wait for pages to load, when you choose a tab, it takes time just to do that. Or you want to decide if you want to open a link in a new tab. Then when I open a new tab, or maybe I just don't need this page anymore, I'll just open it here. You have to actually think about this for a second, just before every time you open a link, and then all these little time wasters just interrupt your state of flow. So I was really inspired with a solution when I came across this XKCD con 2007. And if you follow this, you see you start with one page, and then after a while, you have all the other pages. Some of these are going to be different tabs, and they're all going to be mixed together with other tabs. And what we learned from this is a very important rule that every page, when you're browsing, whether it's a tab or just, you know, either way you click on a new tab or the same tab, doesn't really matter, every page belongs to a tree. So it's either the originating originating node, or just or it's something somewhere along the lines of the tree, but every page belongs to a tree. So what we learned from this is that we need to group pages based on the tree, and therefore that way we can actually separate all the different tasks by separating the trees. And finally, what we really nice if we can take this tree and simplify it in a way that the users can easily comprehend it. So let's say you start off with this this tree structure, so what we can do is rearrange it slightly, and it's like this, getting more linear. And then you can go like this. So basically, we turn this two-dimensional structure into a one-dimensional structure. And this is exactly the structure that you get when you open links in a new tab all the time. If you keep doing that, it'll keep this order, usually. So this is actually not that foreign to people. And this is really how we can utilize that tree insight into something that users can use. So I was also inspired by the zooming interface that Jeff Raskin describes in the UMain interface. Anyone's into design, I highly recommend the book. I couldn't recommend it more seriously. Next, I was also inspired by Palms Web West that they had, and unfortunately not defunct. They came out with 2009. You see their stacks of cards that need to be separated. You see where I'm going here with this, hopefully. So I came up with guidelines for browser design for myself and anyone else wants to design a browser. First, group related pages automatically. No manual organization like almost all those other competitors did. Secondly, keep track of the browsing structure. It's very important. No back button. You don't want to replace the page and then the page is gone, be hidden behind somewhere in the history. If you see a page, that's the page. And finally, instead of tabs, which make it really hard to find things, show the actual pages themselves. So I've actually been working on solutions for this ever since I saw that design challenge. My very first one was this. It's a zoomable interface. It looks just like that XKCD on purpose. Imagine if you turn that into an interface. Next, I refined that into something more linear, one-dimensional. I actually published this online, and Mozilla Labs asked me to blog about it for their blog. And later on, I revised that into, again, a zoomable interface. And finally, I came here to Touro, and I made this interactive mockup over here. And so in designing the current iteration, the GoFlow, I created this user flow to figure out exactly how it should work. And I went through a few sketches trying to figure out a way that I can both design that would make sense in the design and also something I can actually code but I actually coded this thing. And I had this very simple design system based on an 8-pixel grid. There's very, very little UI. It really is all about the content, so it's not a very complicated system. And so let's demo this. Okay, so someone give me any Google search. Yell something out.
Amazon.
Oh. Let's do something a research topic rather than a live website.
Puppies.
Puppies, thank you. Perfect. Let's search for puppies. So first of all, you see when you go to a page full screen, no UI, 100% content, something no one else does. Because you see, UI is completely unnecessary. Now, let's say I want to see images. Every link opens up in a new page here. Because again, these aren't tags. These are the actual pages. Each little window here is actually the page itself. It doesn't get replaced by a new page every time you go open a link. This is the actual page. Now, let's say I want to get rid of this because I only want images today. Do that and throw it away. Now I can also zoom in and again full screen. Let's say I want to open up a bunch of these cool images. So I'm gonna open up that one, and let's say I open up this one. So now I can just move forward this way, and basically the stack is your history. Because you go back, you go to the left, and you go forward, you go right, and once you're really done with a page. I'm not gonna get rid of that one because that's too cute, but I want to get rid of that one. And bye-bye. And let's say I open up another page from here. Notice it opens right here, right next to it. The browser actually keeps track of your actual structure. So every time you create a new page from another one, from a parent, it remembers the structure and the children are always gonna be next to the parent, no matter what. If you go back and forth, it'll keep that structure even then, which browsers don't do. And too many ads, let's get rid of that one. And now let's say I want to do another search. Let's do a Wikipedia search now. Someone give me an idea, something to research, something that's more interesting to research
UI
Wikipedia.
Design.
What?
UI design.
Okay, good idea.
Yes.
Perfect. You can see now, now we are again full screen. Ah, doesn't even know what I'm talking about. It's amazing. Someone should
simplify it.
just for UX. So now I'm going to open a bunch of different things. Let's say I don't know what that is. For example, could it be this? Maybe it's this thing. I don't know. But let me, but before we just continue researching this, let me zoom out a little bit. And what we can see is that, see, every different task here is separated. There's never an intermixing of different tasks. Every time you start a new page from scratch, it's a new stack of pages. And so whenever you're doing a stack of pages, you don't have to zoom out or be distracted by anything else. Your tasks are completely separated, and it's a distraction-free environment. Once you zoom into a page, that's it. You don't see anything else. You can easily get back to the other pages, and they're all organized in a logical order based on that one-dimensional tree structure that I created. But it's still, everything's completely separated, and if you have any more questions about that, you can ask me later. That's basically it. And every time you open a new stack, it's going to be on the top, on the beginning, because I figure it seems more logical for that to be towards the beginning, and more recent things at the beginning. This is, again, something your browsers don't do. So let's continue. So, I actually built this myself, as I said. I used a combination of plain old web technologies together with some ProMap APIs, some stuff that ProMap lets you do, like embed web page with any web page you want. I couldn't do that otherwise. So I had to learn that. And that you just install as a Chrome extension, and that's it. And you have your own app, even a browser. I actually started this because I was trying to figure out how can I use my web development, small amount of web development knowledge to be able to build this, and I asked this on Stack Overflow. I couldn't really get any good answers, but in the end, the ones I found is what was useful enough, and it worked. Next steps, I really want to create a real product out of this, something more than just a demo like this. And so I'm going to continue some testing and refinement to get this in a more presentable way so I can show it to other people. And hopefully that will help me find collaborators, to people, actual real programmers, to build a real thing that I can distribute to people. And from there, hopefully get some of the attention of people who might want to fund it or people who want to start a company. And hopefully I have a whole plan for incremental improvements until I get to the whole actual operating system. It's a whole thing. You can ask me about it later because I have a lot of ideas. Too many for here. Finally, world domination, and of course, I mean, make the world a better place. Thank you very much. Thank you. Yeah.
So, in your research, did you investigate whether what the average would be in terms of parent versus number of parents versus number of children? In other words, some might, for example, have a few parents with a lot of children, while others might have a large number of parents. And it would seem to me that in the latter case, you might run into some issues with the UI.
So that is actually an interesting question. I was actually debating internally if I should... let's say I turn into this. You see how there are all these different pages here, but I was actually debating internally whether I want to expose the structure a little bit in some way within this UI, like maybe they change the height or something, or to show like the top ones are the children, the grandchildren are a little lower, like maybe so something. I have some ideas of different exposing that. Of course, that actually would depend on the number of grandchildren and how deep it usually goes. I would have to test in real life, because that would actually be very relevant to the UI of how I would actually do that if I decided to do that. So, but it really I would have to test it first to see if that even becomes an issue. How big do these stacks become? If it becomes a little less manageable, then you might want to expose that structure a little bit so it's easier to maintain, easy to figure out the connections. So again, it's a question to see the only way to see that is to really start making use it and then see if the issue comes up. So again, really good question.
Can we go home now?
I'm sorry. Thank you guys. Thank you very much.
Thank you.